Brothers and sisters, please, please give yourselves a round of applause for coming back on time. Well done, well done, fantastic. Now, how many of you watched the Conor McGregor and Habib fight? Any fight fans in it? Did you see it? Yeah, man, that feisty boy, him get boss up. Did you see when him start tap? Well, that wasn't no little tapping. You know, oh, God, y'all kill me, y'all kill me. I hate when people talk bad. Him talk so bad. And that man was upset. And he had so much energy. When him start beat McGregor, you know, and I know some of you black people in the room will vex and upset with me, I say this, because you're secret McGregor fans. Yes, it's true. Some black people think same good. He's not, man. And the brother was so upset because the man said some nasty stuff about him father, about him religion. So when the fight done, he still have more energy. He need a next fight. But you see the hypocrisy in this fight business where they're saying, oh, Habib jumped over the cage and he's wrong and he shouldn't have done that. But they never said that when McGregor attacked his coach. Tell you, man. I like a good fight, you know. A good fighter. Aye. Yeah. But you know, someone wanted to say to yourself, him can't do that no more. Love a good fight, man. Love a good fight. Thump up a boy. Hey, boy. Hey, where else? Shape up, you know? We've got to be able to fight, man. Sisters. In fact, the sisters have always been able to fight. It's true. The black woman is a fighter, man. She carried us for 9 months in her womb. And she's carried us for about 400 years on her back, man. This is real. The black woman, you know, you are the most beautiful, the most powerful woman on the planet, honestly. And you just have to believe in yourself, sisters. Just believe in yourself, man. And as brothers, you know, people criticize us in the Nation of Islam. They love to criticize us and call us all kinds of ugly names. But look at my face. You don't see me hiding underneath my bed. I'm not embarrassed. I come out in the public, tell it like it is. Because we're not no liars. We're not dealing with no lies. And we're not dealing with no foolishness and no story. Just truth, man. That's what Jesus said. He said, you shall know the truth. And the truth shall set you free. Truth is really, really critical and important. You know this author, who is the author who is responsible for the book 1984? You know, Big Brother is watching you. George Orwell. By the way, I think his name, his real name, is not even George Orwell, it was Blair. 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 Take off the B. You have liar. But listen to what George Orwell said. George Orwell said, in a time of universal deceit, telling the truth will become a revolutionary act. We're living today, brothers and sisters, in a time of universal deceit. What you're watching on the news about Salisbury and the Russians poisoning somebody, what you're watching on the news about the Saudis and what happened in the Istanbul embassy, what you're watching on the news with this man now, Trump, in the White House, but the way they're trying to get you to focus on Trump, like Trump is the worst thing since sliced bread. Nah, man, let me tell you something. See, we're falling for the hype. Do you realize that Trump is no different to any of them that went before? The only difference between Trump is that Trump is not a trained politician. Trump has no filter between his thoughts and his mouth. Whatever Trump thinks, him saying. And why they're mostly upset with Trump is because he's an embarrassment, because he reveals everything. See, if you ask me to choose between enemies, you say, Leo, what kind of enemy you want? Do you want an enemy that's going to smile in your face, hug you up and tell you all them love you and take out a knife and secretly stab you in your back? Or do you want an enemy that comes in your face and says, black, negro, I don't like you. Give me the second one any day. Any day. Any day. That's what black people need. If Hillary would have become president, oh my God, we would have gone way back to sleep. Not just to sleep, a two duvet we are asleep with. But Hillary was the one who said that black people are, what she call we? What, say it again. No, say it again. Super predators. It was her husband who created the legislation called three strikes and you're out. Which then meant that on the third strike, you could be guilty of stealing a loaf of bread, but you're going to prison for life. And it destroyed hundreds of thousands of black families. And there are millions of black people right now in prison in America as a result of that Bill Clinton policy. No, I'm not defending Trump. I mean, I like him. But I prefer a man who don't like me to tell me him don't like me. I don't like the hypocrisy. But you see, before him it was Obama. And they did everything in their power to disrespect that man. Did you know that Barack Obama was the most threatened president in the history of the presidency? And that they were openly racist to him? But you see, now, them wish them did have an Obama in the White House. Because you see, once you go black, anyway, listen, could you come up here, please, Aziza? 26 years ago, I stood on this stage and I held a little baby in my arms. Here she is. My wife had just given birth to her and I held her in my arms. She was fresh. Look upon her now, pure trouble. 26. This was the first one that I delivered myself. Myself. The midwife was vexed. She was in our bedroom while me and my wife was in the front room. I'm going to just take care of business. Since this one, how many have we delivered now since?
So many.
Jamila.
Sauda.
Jana. Asad. Never Asad. And I deliver all my children myself. Myself. Just me and my wife. I just wanted you to see, because she's never had an injection. I want you to hear me. A lot of our children are coming down now with autism. And I know some of you, when I talk like this, it's one of them conspiracy things. Let me tell you something. The people that are the enemies of our rise, they don't play. And when you see them going all over Africa, injecting our people about birth control, understand what's being done. This is real, brothers and sisters, and our people are dying today. Did you know that? All right, let me go there, because I know someone want to vex me. I'll make you even vex up. Do you realize that AIDS is man-made? Do you understand that Ebola is man-made? I hope you do. Because these people ain't playing, man. And you be very careful what you put into your children or allow them to put into you. Because they have a death plan for us. Because what they recognize is that it's your time. And these young people, our little boys and girls on the street, that you see them walking with their trousers down, do you realize that they've been programmed to have their trousers down? Thank you, Aziza. That's my daughter. They've been programmed to have their trousers down and them underpants unsure. They're subject to programming. These young people are stabbing and killing one another. And I'm telling you, man, when you go to the prisons and you visit them in there and you see them, they're holding their head, they don't even know why they did it. Many of them are killing their own friends because they are subject to a program. And it's all in the music and it's all in the food. You see this chicken that we love to eat? I'm not playing. You see this Nando's and Kentucky? Be careful, brothers and sisters. See, it's not an accident that when you are cowardly, somebody call you a chicken. It's not an accident. You need to watch chickens. Frighten them. And these young people are killing each other because they're frightened. They're fearful. They haven't got confidence. Many of them don't see themselves living into old age. This is reality. And I'm saying, any parents in the house? Parents, stop trying to make your children your best friend. Stop it. Stop it. Be a parent. You want the definition of parent? Or you pay the rent? You're paying the mortgage. You are in charge. Stop being afraid of the government. And your children are telling you, if you hit me, I call social services. Let me tell you something, man. Brothers and sisters, I think the first act is going to be ready to go in a second. But brothers and sisters, Felix Dexter, he lived among us. And he died among us. And life and death is real. There is not one of us in this room that's going to get out of life alive. I want you to think about that. The one thing that's guaranteed is that you and I, our day is coming. But we should not be in the least bit afraid of that day. Did you know that you actually cannot die? See, this flesh, it goes back into the earth. But do you appreciate, brothers and sisters, that there's something in you that's bigger than your flesh? Do you understand spirit or energy? Or electricity? Do you know that energy, which is the real you? Do you know that nobody ever has ever met you? Do you know that when your mom or your dad says, yeah, I know you, you're my son, you're my daughter, they've never met you? Do you know that if they were to invent a machine that they could put on our heads that could read our minds, people would be shocked at what we think individually? Because no one knows our thoughts but ourselves. No one really knows the person behind these eyes. The closest you can get to ever seeing another human being is looking directly into their eyes, not their form. All of us think that this thing is so important. We think these things are so important. We think this form is... No, brothers and sisters, you're bigger than all of that. There's something greater. Are we ready? Beautiful. There's something greater. And before we end this evening, I want you to leave this place thinking about your greater self and your destiny and what we can achieve and what we can accomplish if we would only think. Think. As a man, as a woman thinketh, so is he. So is she. We are our thoughts. Think about what you think about, brothers and sisters. Very, very important. This next artist has been entertaining us for years, and he's very, very powerful and very beautiful. And so without further ado, I want you to put your hands together and welcome to the stage to kick us off in our second half. Please welcome Mr. Dennis Bovell. Make some noise.
Hey, how you doing out there? Hey, what up there, pull up the music. Ladies and gentlemen, I got to tell you that Felix is always on my mind, especially when I think of this little ditty. Tree man depan death row for dead, electric chair. The first one go up, them said to him, what you have to say before we pull the plug for you? Him said, nothing. They put him in the chair, pulled the plug, nothing happened. They had to let him go. The second man go up, him said, what you have to say before we torture? Said nothing. Pulled the thing. Nothing happened. They must have let him go. The third man go up. Said, what you have to say? Him say, when you see the machine no plug in. Run the rhythm. This one's for you, Felix. Take a look at it from my point of view. And when you really find out that I love you too, whoa, 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 whoa. The love I got inside is so unkind. It's a cool, gentle touch, and yet it hurts me so much. I need to squeeze a little loving out of you. I said I need to squeeze a little more of me. I need you, baby. But we've been together for such a long time. Gee, it makes me feel so good to know that you're mine. Oh, baby. Now love is a secret not to be told. Never find out until the day you grow old. But I could squeeze a little out of you. I said I need to squeeze a little more loving. I need you, baby. Well, don't you know I need you? Well, love is a secret not to be told, and you'll never find out until the day you grow old. But I could squeeze a little loving out of you. You know I need you. Squeeze a little more loving. I need you, baby. Well, you know I love you. Question why I just follow my heart until the day that I die. I need to squeeze a little loving out of you. You know I need you. I squeeze a little more loving. I need you, baby. Well, don't you know I need you? Oh, baby. Well, ABC. Give it to me. 1, 2, 3, 4. You know that I want some more. Baby. A, B, C, D. Give it to me. 1, 2, 3, 4. You know. Thank you. Well, some time ago I was a member of a band called Matumbi. And we had a good time. So I want you all to join us in the time that we had tonight so you all can have a good time. Is that okay?
Yeah.
All right, run the music. Whoa. Yeah. Wall up there. Turn down the microphone, my youth. I'm going to take feedback on them something there, you know. I'm going to want a man come spoiled by a moment here, sir. Don't turn me up. I can shout. Turn down the mic outside. The bass frequency too loud. Turn down the bass frequency. Yeah. You hear that? Oh. I don't want deaf. The people that pay their money don't want deaf them. I can't get that to understand at all. Music, sir. Whoa! Now. Can you do it? Sing one. Come again. Yeah. My baby. Ow. Listen here. I said the man in me will do almost any task. It asks for compensation, this little that he would ask. It takes a woman like you to get through to the man in me. Yeah. It takes a woman like your kind. We'll find the man in me. Yeah. Whoa. You know, I really mean it, y'all. Sing one. Louder. I said, yeah. Well, baby, yeah. When storm clouds are raging all around my door, I think to myself, I just can't make it anymore. It takes a woman like you to get through to the man in me. It takes a woman like your kind. We'll find the man in me. And I gotta say, whoa, what a wonderful feeling. Just to know that you are near me. And my baby, it sets my heart reeling. From my toes, right up to my ears, yes. The man in me will hide some time to keep from being seen. But baby, that's just because he doesn't wanna turn into some machine. It takes a woman like you to get through. To the man in me, baby. It takes a woman like your kind to find. We'll find the man in me, baby. It takes a woman like you to get through to the man in me.
We don't have time. I don't got time. I gotta go, but before I do, I wanna let you into a secret.
I got an email from Ancestry.com. Me say, uno. Them say, you don't know we, but we know you. I said, oh. Them say, you and your band Matumbi contributed to the British birth rate. Me say, well, we only have 6 people. And me you know, well, that was my contribution. Them say, yeah. I'm gonna write a song that a lot of people sing it, and a lot more people went and carried the actions through. I said, what? I said, yes, your song was covered by at least 23 different artists, including one group named UB40. I said, me dear sir. They said, yes, that tune was called Baby. Run the rhythm. We go. Hey. Yeah, man, I saw we do it in wallpaper style. Oh, I'm the key to set you free. You can come to me anytime for cover. I don't play shy. You better let me try. Coming to you, I really want it, not another. Listen. So baby, don't you find, oh, get your little self uptight, you know. You know, oh, oh. On the night, let's hear ya. Oh, baby,
after tonight.
Lord of mercy. A baby. Or maybe twins. A baby. Triplets running out of family. A baby.
Oh.
Now come alive. Won't you take a dive? Won't you swim to me a little bit closer? Cause I can't read what you need, and it's you, baby, you that I'm booking after. I've a serenade. Oh, 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 yeah. Ha. So, baby, don't you find, oh, get your little self uptight, you know. No, oh, oh. Sing with me. Oh, baby.
After tonight.
Louder, man. Oh, baby.
After tonight.
Baby. Oh, baby.
After tonight.
Baby. Oh, baby. Oh, baby.
After tonight.
It's gonna be all right. You know. Excuse me. I've got to make a few babies. Oh, baby, don't you find, oh, get your little self uptight, cause you know, you know, oh, 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 baby,
after tonight,
huh? Oh, baby, nice. Oh, baby,
after tonight.
Oh, baby, after tonight. Oh, baby, oh, baby, after tonight, it's gonna be alright. Ah, thank you. Enjoy the rest of the evening.
Come on, brothers and sisters, one more time for Mr. Dennis Bovell. All right. All right, all right, all right. From one legend to another. Brothers and sisters, ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together, make some noise, show some love for Mr. Junior Giscombe!
Evening. Evening. I was saying backstage, it's funny. When I was a youth and I used to go out and I used to sit on and watch people perform. And what used to get me was the fact that you had ushers down the middle and them used to stop you from get up and dance. But I noticed everybody though, well, get up, welcome. Wake up. All right, we could try this, yeah? I'm going to get you to sing with me before I start the show. So give me a clap, you know. I don't want you to clap me, I want you to clap with me. One, two, three, clap! Everybody!
Said a small boy once asked, when will I grow up? When will I see what grown-ups do see? In his fight to come of age, he would have to know the age to be recognized as one and not a mess. Sing! Mama used to say, and Mama used to say, and Mama used to say, and Mama used to say,
louder! Louder! Nobody tell you to stop clapping up. Come on!
As the years went rushing by, he would cut down on his age. He would tell his girl of how it used to be. How his mommy passed away, but these lines she would say. And at the time he couldn't understand. And Mama used to say, and Mama used to say, and Mama used to say, and Mama used to say,
and again, one more time, play that tune.
Again now,
gone again, hey. Get up, man, get up.
Hey now.
Come on, get up.
Get now.
Come on.
Get now. Get now. Said a small boy once asked, when will I grow up? When will I see what grown-ups do see? In his fight to come of age, he would have to know the age to be recognized as one and not a mass. And Mama used to say, take your time, young man.
That's right.
And Mama used to say, don't you rush to get old. And Mama used to say, take it in your stride. And Mama used to say, live your life. As the years went rushing by, he would cut down on his age. He would tell his girl of how it used to be. How his mommy passed away, but these lines she would say. At the time he couldn't understand. And Mama used to say, take your time, young man. And Mama used to say, don't you rush to get old. And Mama used to say, take it in your stride. Mama used to say, live your life. Live your life. You'll be young, so enjoy. Don't hold on back. Do all you want to do. Now is the time for you to try, for you to get better in what you are doing. Oh, Mama used to say, yeah, now. Mama used to say, that's right. Said a small boy once asked, when will I grow up? When will I see what grown-ups do see? In his fight to come of age, he would act an older age to be recognized as one and not a man. Sing with me. Mama used to say, and Mama used to say, Mama used to say, take it in your stride. Mama used to say, live your life, live your life, live your life, oh yeah. Mama used to say, take your time, young man. Mama used to say, don't you rush to get old. Mama used to say, take it in your stride. Mama used to say, live your life, 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 live this life, live some life, yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah. Woo. My mama used to say, Mama used to say, Mama used to say, live some life, live your life. Thank you very much.
Hey, nobody sit down, you know. Nobody with that. A few years ago, before Felix died, I did a show with him, and it was the first time I'd ever done a show with him, and he was very shy, came across very shy, didn't really say too much, but before, he went on before me, and when I was going on, he said there was one song of mine that was his favourite song, and I think it's yours too. Drop this. That's why I'm saying, no, but I see them, get up, get up, get up, get up! Yeah, ladies, can't hear you. Woo!
Ooh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Come with me now. It is our days when the warm light of the sun feels your life now, in making a way that you follow, oh so clear. Nothing can go wrong, and now you're moving in the positive way. Skylark, she's singing, seems to sing a special song. Just you
sing.
Morning will come.
Don't hear
you. With the rise of the sun, showing me the way I must live. At the dawn of that day, spirits will rise
to do what?
To find a new way. Look around. broken promises. Too many people living a life, changing faces day to day. Money in pocket seems to buy away a life, not happiness. We must find a way to live and give all of ourselves. I wanna know just what it is, this spirit coming over me. Just where to find it. Oh, morning will come with the rise of the sun. Show me the way I must live. At the dawn of that day, spirits will rise to find the new way. Morning will come with the rise of the sun, showing me the way I must live. At the dawn of that day, spirits will rise to find the new way. Yeah, yeah, woo, yeah. You know what you gotta do, you break down. Woo! Mm. Ooh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Ooh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Thank you.
Brothers and sisters, do you realize what we got? Give it up one more time for Mr. Junior Giscombe. Wow. All we need to do now is get these young people to start writing some proper lyrics. Some music that's going to become iconic music like that music, man. Tonight, we got royalty in the house, and so without further ado, I want you to put your hands together and show him some love. This young man is going to make you laugh. Please give it up one time for Prince Abdi!
Wow, how you guys doing? Ready for some comedy? Because I cannot sing, so... Nice to be here, man. I had to jump on this, man, because I've known Felix for a long time, so it was nice to come and show some support. I'm at that age now where I avoid confrontations. I don't like getting into confrontations. When I was younger, I'd fight if you look at me. Nowadays, I avoid it. Seriously, man. I had a little conversation the other day. I was on the bus, and this youth got on, and out of everyone, he spoke to me. Now, I know that I'm not down with the youth, because what he said to me next, I didn't know what it meant. He looked at me and went, "Hey, bruv." I said, "Yes." He goes, "Is this bus going to London Bridge?" I said, "Yes." Then he goes, "Say no more." okay, I won't say anymore. He didn't think it through though, because about five stops later, he goes to me, is this London Bridge? I didn't say anything. He missed it by five stops. Not that what he used, man. I was in Northwest London recently. I was on my way to a show, and I didn't know that youth still fight over areas and postcodes and territories. I was on my way to a show. I got surrounded by about 20 youths. One of the youths looked at me and he went, hey, stop, bruv. I was already in standstill. He went, stop. Where in London are you from, bruv? And they all joined in, yeah, bruv. Where in London are you from? They all joined, yeah, bruv. Where in London are you from, bruv? They had a little kid about 5 years old. Yeah, bruv. Where in London are you? Where's this kid coming from? What the? I panicked because I didn't know what answer was correct, you know? It's a trick question. So I panicked. I looked at him. I was like, I'm from Scotland. Hey, I see you later. Hey. I kid you not. One of the youth was like, rah, a black Scottishman. That wasn't the awkward part. The awkward part was that I went to the show and those kids I just lied to turned up to the show. I had to do my whole routine with a Scottish accent. That was, I was like, hey, dear, hey, my name is Abdi McGregor. Love Scotland, man. I got heckled by a Scottish man recently. I didn't know what he was saying. He was so drunk. It was very difficult to deal with him. It was in Glasgow. Halfway through my set, he just went, hey, you, hi, hi. Yeah, hi. I didn't have to deal with him. The guy behind him bottled him. He went, shut up, you wee prick. Then he looked at me and went, carry on. Scotland's dangerous. I don't smoke. I don't do drugs either. I don't smoke either. I tried weed once. Not for me. One time I smoked so much weed, I called work, told them I was sick, and then I turned up. That shit was powerful. I turned up to work. My manager was like, you just called in sick. I was like, I love this place. He sat me on a spot. Before I did stand up, I used to be a teacher. I used to be a supply teacher. And I remember my first day I went to the school. Right? And this kid was just jumping up and down on the table. All the kids were sitting down listening. So I said to this kid, right, you need to get down and get on with your work. You have to do your voice, you know, that school teacher voice. He looks at me, this kid's 7 years old. He goes, no, I tell my dad, he just came out of prison and he'll go again. I did not speak to him for the whole day. But then after, I saw his dad, I spoke to his dad, found out his dad was a prison officer. This little kid tricked me. And his dad was from Jamaica. Not British Jamaican, he was Jamaican Jamaican. Because as soon as I told his dad, all I heard was this. Kieran, Kieran, come here, come here, come here. I want to tell the people upon a few people, you're grounded, you're grounded. I didn't know what he said, but I'm like, that's a good dad. I really liked him. He used to come in the morning and, you know, he was always friendly, but I'll be honest, I didn't know what he would say. Like, he used to get excited. He would speak slow. He'll be like, good morning, I'm like, good morning, Mr. Jones. Everything all right? Yes, everything is fine. Now, I didn't know what he'd say next, but I used to just agree with him. Hey, black people, I want to people, every time someone like people, I'm going to tell you something, eh? Yes, absolutely true, yes. He's a cool guy, though, right? Cool guy. Cool guy. I recently got pulled over by the police, right? It's been a while, I'll be honest. Like, I haven't been pulled over by the police recently. It was my fault. I was on a bus lane right, in the morning. I was in a hurry. And I didn't know the police would pull you over for that. I thought you'd just get a fine from the, you know, Transport for London. No, they pulled me over. It was a black officer and a white officer, right? And when the white officer saw me, he got a black officer to come and speak to me. I'm not making this up. And this black officer was a Nigerian gentleman, right? And he just said to me, he was very upset with me. He's like, what are you doing? You were on the bus line, what are you doing? And instead of just talking back normal, I put on a Nigerian accent. I didn't mean to, I just went, I'm sorry, my brother. I should have done that. Then he looked at me, he's like, are you Nigerian? I was like, no. So he got really upset, he left. He got the white officer to come and speak to me. Then the white officer goes, oh, what's going on, mate, what's going on? I was like, I don't know, mate, I don't know. But what's going on, mate? You know what I mean? I got fined, man. Sometimes putting on accents can, like, you can get away with, like, stuff, putting on accents. Because, like, right now, you know, we're, this is the Brexit time. I was on a bus once, and I was upstairs on this bus, and this white, drunk English guy got on, very xenophobic. He was downstairs. I could hear him. All I heard was this.
Oh, yeah. Where are you from?
And the guy goes, Poland.
How about you? Where are you from?
The guy goes, Italy.
And you? Where are you from?
The guy goes, Romania. Then he goes,
that's what I mean. All you foreigners coming over here, taking our jobs. Then he goes, Brexit. Brexit.
I was like, damn.
Then he goes, right, I'm going to go upstairs.
I was like, I'm not having this. So immediately I shut downstairs.
You stay down there, mate. And I'll sort upstairs out.
He was so drunk, he couldn't see me. He just went,
who's up there?
I don't know why. I was like, Clive.
All right, Clive, I'm Terry.
You sorted the foreigners upstairs?
I'll sort the foreigners downstairs.
I don't know why. I was like,
Britain first. Then he said, BNP.
Then I said, UKIP.
Then he said, free Tommy Robinson.
Then I said,
yeah.
And the people upstairs are like, what are you doing? I'm like, I don't want him coming upstairs. I'm kidding, I was the only one upstairs. I didn't think it through though, just like that kid that said to me, you know, say no more. I didn't think it through. About 7-8 stops later, right, I had to get off. I just lied to him. But he was quiet, I thought he got off the bus. So I was like, Terry, you still down there, mate? And he went,
yeah, mate.
So I went, I'm sending one of the foreigners down.
But he's all right, he is. He went, send that foreigner down. Oi, foreigner, go downstairs.
I went downstairs. He stopped me, went, hang on a minute. Then he went, I'm going to have to let you off.
Only because Clive said so.
I don't know why. I was like, thank you, my friend. And I got off. I do like people doing people's accents, man. I do, man. I was in Australia. Never been to Australia before. It was my first time, right? And if you haven't been to Australia, just go there, just for experience. It's a whole different ball game. I went there. I had an argument with this Australian guy, right? It was over a chair outside this coffee shop. So I went to grab this chair, right, to sit next to my friend. He grabbed it and he went, what are you doing, mate? It's my chair. Sorry, but that's how they sound. He was like, what are you doing, mate? It's my chair. I couldn't help it. I was like, nah, mate, it's my chair. Then he got really upset. He's like, it's my chair, mate. I was here first. It's my chair. I was here first. Straight away, I was just like, mate, I'm an Aboriginal. I was here first. Good night. Thank you very much. God bless you all. Peace.
Come on, brothers and sisters, one more time for Prince Abdi.
Beautiful, man, beautiful. Was that funny? Fantastic, man. So there's a bit of an imbalance. Our mechanic component here is pure man. So we're gonna balance things up now, bring in some female energy, some estrogen. Too much testosterone, Panacea.
So, she is one of our finest. She's been on the circuit making us laugh for many, many years. Without further ado, I want you to show her some absolute love. A white woman actress stole her name. She's now taking it back. Please give it up for Glenda Jackson!
Okay, no music. All right, now watch that. Hello, everyone! God, blimey. When I told my kids I was coming out, they thought it was another Black History Month. I said, no. Because they think I went to school with God, yeah? They asked me, who's older, me or God? I don't know. But anyway, with all my big girls in the house, let me hear you. Yeah, there's more of you. I understand you don't want to say nothing to yourself. But you know what? I'm aware I'm saying that because one day, a couple of years' time, I'm going to be slim. Yeah. Because I'm on a diet, people. I'm on a diet. I've been on a diet since January, nothing's happened, but still. I've been on a diet. Every Monday, Wednesday, Friday, I start the diet. Yeah, that's right. I wake up every Monday and I take my little juice and I eat it. I say, oh, look at me, slim, yes. About 12 o'clock, I do the same thing, all slim. 5 o'clock, I put the tracksuit on, the trainers and everything. I even put the towel around my neck, you know, to make me look like I'm doing something. I put the headphones on and I make my way down to the gym. But the only thing about you people, I never reach the gym. I actually have a blackout. I don't even know what happened. But then I wake up in Nando's. Yes. I wake up in Nando's and I look at the food and I say to the woman, what happened? She says, you do this every Monday, Wednesday and Friday. I said, really? She said, what happened? She said, when you come in, you order the food, you look at the food and you faint. So I said, what are you going to do with the food? She said, throw it away. I said, bring it here, let me. But then I said to myself, I need to lose weight because if I'm doing that, nothing's going to happen. So I went to the doctor. I said, doctor, I need to lose weight. He said to me, what made you do that? He's glad, yeah? I said, well, look, the other day I was in my house and I was looking in the mirror and I said to my husband, who's that behind me? And he said, you. I said, all right, cool. So he said, what kind of diet do you want to be? Because you've been on every kind of diet, the diet you don't go, the diet you don't keep up. I said, I want to go to a place where there's pure fat people, doctor. I just want to see pure fat girl, my people, them. Lots and lots of, like you see, like there, pure fat people, that's what I want. I want to walk in there and feel at home and say to them when I get in, here, I'm me there. Welcome, I just feel fat. And I went to this place, but before I actually went to the doctor, I had to say goodbye to the food that got me in this situation in the first place. So I went home and I put the chicken there, fried chicken. I put the chips there. I don't know what the salad was doing there. The salad was unwanted guests. I didn't even know what. I said, who are you? He said, salad. I said, where did you get in my house? He said, you were in the fridge for 5 years. I said, really? All right then. So I went over to the chicken and there was a heart-to-heart conversation. I said, chicken, I've got to leave you, you know. I know you've been around me for a long time. Look, I can still see you around me. Chicken was crying. Oh, chicken was going, Glenn, don't do that to me, man. Don't do that to me. I said, chicken, I've got to go. The chips is facing now. Chips is saying, don't watch her. Don't listen to her. Don't watch her. I said to chips, you're out of order. And you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to eat you. And never talk to me like that again. Anyway, I was so stressed and I'm talking to the food I can't see no more. I said, you know what? Before I go and I hear things are hard in the KFC, I thought, let me just go and back a bucket now. I just don't mind. Nobody's going to, you know, because as you get to a certain age, you shouldn't really eat in the street, but I couldn't care less. Because I had a mission, I was going to the diet club, and I thought, let me yam up that 24 pieces, yeah? And I never knew you could do that in 5 minutes. Oh, it was all... Anyway, so I get down to the diet, I see all these fat people there, I said, look at my sisters there. And you know, we go kind of different fat, you know, when they see us, they start, you know, because fat, you know, they're looking, because we got beef as well, do you know what I mean? So they're looking at each other, and they're doing all that, you know that one there? Because that's all we really can do, because we're so fat, yeah? But that's how big we were. And then, you know, some fat people look at other fat people, you know, they're eye looking at each other. Because when fat people see another fat person, they're not fat no more. Do you know that one day? Oh, not like you. There was all kind of fat. There was the fat that looked like me, which my sons called me an upside down triangle. There was that kind of fat. Oh, I love my children. There was that kind of fat. You got the fat with the big tits and no bottom. You got the one with no bottom. You know them kind of fat people. You got the fat person with the lump under the arm, but really, he's a little bald-headed man, but it's fat. It's fat. Yes. Oh, we were all there. We were happy. We was a family. Oh, God. Anyway, we stood there, and all the fat people were there looking at each other. So all of a sudden, there was a big woman there. She was big, she was about 7 or 8. She was massive, white girl. Just sitting in the front. She said to everybody, stand up and say who you are. So I got up first. I said, excuse me, hi, my name is Glenda Jackson, international superstar. Yeah. Another one stood up, another one stood up. The biggest, fattest woman in the place stood up. And she said to me, hey, my name is Sandra, and I am your dietitian. I said, shut up. Shut up, you liar. You lying. Sandra, what happened to you? You're lying, Sandra. Sandra, what are you going to tell me, Sandra? Sandra, are you going to tell me not eat that, Sandra? You not eat that, Sandra. Don't watch me. She said, I think you should leave. I said, that's right, I'm going. So I look at the other fat girls. I said, what are we doing? They said, we're going. I said, come on. There was about 100 of us walking down the high road. Upset, stumping. We're just upset, upset, hungry, upset, hungry, upset. And then we saw it. It was like, eat as much as you like. I said, what you say? They say, yeah. So we went inside. And we started to eat and talk at the same time. Boom. Hello. Boom. Boom. The Chinese man come up to you, very upset. No, you need no stop, start. You need stop that. Why you do? Stop, please, God, stop. You make me lose my business. Stop. I said, what's wrong with you? He said, you eat too much. I said, it said, eat as much as you like, and we like. Anyway, he went and called the police. I said, all right then. So I said, I'm gonna meet up with them, but really, not really. So me and my friend went to the shop. She went to get something to wear. She's not skinny, but I tell her, I always say, you look slim, because you know, sometimes you have to tell them a lie. She's not fat like me anyway. So I was so bored, I thought, let me go and try one of these clothes. It said, one size fit all. So I put it on me, you know, and it was one of them two dresses. It's got no top, you know, you just pull it, you know, then one there. Anyway, my friend said she heard one scream, and she run in the change room, and there was me, the dress did roll up, start strangling me, round my neck, I couldn't breathe. I said, what? Take this. She said, what is it? I said, a dress. She said, what? I couldn't believe it. Anyway, I had to buy the dress. I said, oh, I nearly died. How can you imagine that in the newspaper? A girl getting hung up by her dress. You know, I tried to do a lot of work. I tried to do a lot of jogging. I tried to run, and I can't run people. I've got arthritis, rheumatitis, da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da- have got their own mind, you see. This is the good one and this is the bad one. So sometimes when I'm running, I can hear the bad one say, leave her, leave her. No, leave her, leave her. She don't fall down, leave her. She that's what she wants to do. Leave her. The good one's saying, don't do that, don't do that. Don't, leave her. So anyway, I try to run for the bus, you know, and all of a sudden I'm on the floor. Now I've been falling down for so long, I pretend that's what I really want to do. Do you know what I'm saying? So I fall down and stay there, and people say, you're right. I go, no, it's all right, I'm just looking. Oh, yeah, look at the floor, yeah. And I'm looking at them big guys that just come to the gym. I'm thinking, one of them picked me up, but they never, they always got a bad back, you know? So I'll try to get up on my own. I say, it's all right, you know, I'll get ignorant. It's all right, don't need you. But I make a mistake and I roll on my back. Now I can't move, nanny. I'm trying to get up like. Anyway, I got up after I farted a lot, but still. Can't get anything. So I want to go on the bus now because I got my shopping, innit? So I get on the bus and the driver's telling me to sit down. He says, sit down, you know, but you hear people talking about it. They've got that voice, you know, like, it's all right. It's all right. It's all right. So I kind of try to get up, and I go on the bus, and I stand with the driver, you know, I just stand there like that. And you can sit down if you want. I say, it's all right, thank you very much. I just want to... Anyway, the driver's going, all I'm hearing in my mind is, driver, don't stop at all. Just take me home. Because I want to cry, people. See, there's a cry that you do in front of your friends at work. There's a cry that you do to your little friend. Well, I'm from Dominica. I wanted to give the whole. I wanted to cry and talk. I wanted to get to my mom's house and say, Mommy, I want down again. I cannot do this no more, Mom. So I got to my mom, I did all the crying. She looked at me and she said, of course you'll fall down because you're fat. And I thought, shoot, there's a camera in the place, Mom, you're all right. Because now I'm my mom's carer. Anybody carer in here? Yeah, I'm my mom's carer. I was her daughter for a couple of years ago, you know. But now all of a sudden, I'm her carer. I'm not her daughter no more, I'm the carer. And because she asks you, every Monday, you get the £64. And I go, yeah, and then it starts. She just wants me to do anything. I finish. She's got four carers, but I am the extra one. And she just wants me to do everything. Everything. But then there's nothing for me to do, people. So she'll make up things, you know what I'm saying? I want to go home and she'll say, oh, Glenda, get me that thing over there. I go, where? She go, let me see. I'll pick up an empty cup. I said that. She said, yes, that's what I want. Yeah, so as I told her, I got arthritis. And they tell me not to be rude and no swearing, but I'm going to tell you a little story quickly. So my husband had a stroke. Yes, he had a stroke. Not one of them one day, but he had a stroke. Now, see, when I say that, people laugh, and I laugh as well. Some people get offended. I'm just telling you, he didn't do the full one. He done a little bit of one. Yeah, he stopped halfway, yeah? And every now and again, he'd ask me for the thing, you know? And I'll say to him, what? Now, he gets upset because he can't talk a bit, you know, so he gets a bit frustrated, you know what I'm saying? And I know what he's asking for, but I think let's have a little laugh, you know, sometimes. Yeah, no, it's not just me. It's just sometimes a little laugh. And he'd ask me for the thing, and I'll say, what? And he'd say, you ding. And I'll say, what? What? And he'd say, you ding, you ding. And I'll say to him, well, I don't know what you're talking about. And he'd get, you ding, you ding. I said, don't talk to me like that. Don't talk to me like that. Say what you want slowly. You ding, you ding. You're right. Oh, no, I can't get to you. I've got arthritis. All my body's hurting. I said, but you didn't have arthritis today. Why don't you try that move? You remember that come home the other day, you was on the floor and your leg was there. I said, I fell down. What are you talking about? What's this? So anyway, he asked for the thing. If I say no, you know how certain man turn, I'm a lesbian all of a sudden. Do you know what I'm saying? And telling me how he knows that he's one, you know. You just see it in your eye. You walk like one. Yes, you know. I said, because I said no. Anyway, I thought, I'll give him the thing. So I said to him, come on, hurry, I've got things to do. Come on, come on, come on. Come on, come on, come on. Come on. EastEnders is on, Richard's on. Come on. So anyway, true that I do what I have to do, and he goes to work. Remember, I've got arthritis, innit? So my knees are locked, see? I can see the phone, but I can't get no near. So he'll come back inside, and he'll say to me, oh, you're waiting for me, and he'll start all over again. I said, people. I've got two children, one boy and one nuts. A next boy, love them to bits. But the other one, the young one, he's a rapper somebody, yeah? He's a what's it, E-D, what, ain't got a clue. And he'd ask me for money to go to uni. He'd say, mum, you got your money. And all I'd say to him, no, and he gets upset. But no laughing. So, before I go, I'm just going to let you know, any Jamaicans in the house? I said, any Jamaicans in the house? You lot are bad. Let me tell you what, my husband's from Jamaica, but he lives in Hackney. I don't understand. But he's from Jamaica. And when he met me, I'm from Dominica, my parents, so I don't know nothing. Zaka fe-a-a. My husband told me, looked at my face and he said to me, gal, your face roll like Bami. I didn't know what Bami was. I thought Bami was nice. So I'm walking around going, oh my God, my face is round like Bami. I walk past a West Indian restaurant one day, I see this yellow Marie sitting in the window. I said to the woman, what's that? She said, Bami. I said, you're a liar. She said, Mommy, you like idiots? I phoned him, I said, guess what, sweetheart? I just met Mommy. I mean, I'll do the thing tonight. Thank you very much. Good night.
Come on, brothers and sisters, one more time for Glenda Jackson. I think she was trying to make up for the lack of estrogen. All right, without further ado, he's young, he's black, he's handsome. No, man, we gotta talk about Richard Black. Richard Black with no young, handsome, and black. He's young, he's black, he's handsome, he's got the proper bad boy smile. Put your hands together, make some noise for our brother, Kojo!
Shut up. Who said Richard Blackwood? Oh, is it? Ah. All right. You're the person that no one wanted to be here, innit? Just join the WhatsApp group. Good evening, everybody. Are we good? Yeah. Give a round of applause for Felix Dexter, please. Give a round of applause for Felix. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm not going to be here long. I don't have jokes. I've got problems in my life.
I'm going to get through a few of those. Now, I want to kind of know what kind of people we have in the house tonight. Have we got honest people? Make some noise. All right. How many people in here have gone to the bank and needed whatever was left? Okay, some people in denial, whatever. I just come from there today. I needed the rest of it. I'm going through something in my life, ladies and gentlemen. But what I didn't appreciate is when I got to the cashier, they now have given the cashiers microphones so everybody can hear your financial situation. I'm going in there, I'm already embarrassed about the amount I need, right? So I'm already discreet. I'm like, can I have £1.50, please? That wasn't enough for her. She was like, excuse me, sir, you need £1 to keep the account open. I'm like, why are you shouting? Tell me I'm right here. Can I have 50 pence, please? She said, how do you want that? I was like, in silence. This, because of my money situation, there's certain things I don't use anymore, like black taxis. They ain't getting my money, right? I'm an Uber man. I got here today in an Uber, and I can relax in an Uber, innit? Yeah? Because it's already paid for. So now you can look outside the window. You can enjoy the ride. You can lie down, talk to the driver. Right? When you get into a black taxi, they take your money before they chat to you. You step in there, £2.50, you're like, rah! You sit down, £3, hey! Let's discuss this. It's got to a point now, I don't even have a destination anymore. When the driver says, where do you want to go? I say, take me to £5. I will walk the rest, it can't be that far. Wherever I end up, that's where I was going anyway. I got problems in my life, man. People with bad breath. Yeah, yeah. Some of them in here now, I've been hearing you laugh. You know, bad breath people laugh like this. They keep it on the inside. You ever met someone with bad breath so bad, you can see the words come out their mouth? Think about how nasty that is. Every time they finish a sentence, you're like, yeah, I see what you're saying. I see what you're talking about. Why is it people with bad breath always want to come close and tell a secret, innit? They've always got a rumor. Guess what? Mm-mm. Text me. Text me. When I come in here tonight and I see some grown people in here, some grown people. People over 30, make some noise. That's my kind of people there, man. My kind of people. Yeah, that means you kind of in the same era as me, like school times. Remember school times, we had some good games, yeah? Not like the kids now where they got computer and everything in their bedroom. Yeah, we had to leave the house and play games. Especially at school. Remember Kids Chase? Yeah. Yes, some of you don't know what I'm talking about. You went to a boys' school, right? It was called PE. Yeah? Kids Chase was fun, but you can never catch the pretty girls, innit? Because pretty girls had pace. They were fast, innit, guys? And you chase them all over the place, because you couldn't catch them for nothing. It's the girl that you didn't like, innit, guys? Yeah? You chase them for 2 seconds. Oh, you caught me.
You caught me. Guys, we all done the same thing.
Don't worry. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm a new father. I've got a son now. Roman, that's my son, Roman.
And I have one thing, I just want to be better than my dad.
That's what I want to do. I want to be better than my dad, right? Because my dad had no patience. And as a parent, especially a new parent, you have to have patience. Okay, whether you have it or not, it is forced upon you, okay? And my dad didn't have that. For example, do you have any Jehovah's Witnesses in the house? Okay, let's talk about them.
I'm giving them a little time, you know what I mean? Because they're not here tonight, because they're getting ready for tomorrow. To tear down our door, innit? And I don't know anybody in here personally, okay? But I'm sick and tired of hiding in my own house where I pay the bills. Because they don't give up, do they? Just...
You're in your house like, get down!
My dad, typical African man, he put us up to that foolishness one time. They've not been back since. My dad answered the door naked. He was like,
my family's Christian, right? I'm coming from Christian background. That's my family. Pentecostal, right? Pure singing. Okay, little message. Pure singing, little message. Right? And I used to blame my pastor as the reason why church goes on for so long, especially in a black church. Because much like tonight, they'll advertise they finish at one time and you leave at the next time. Yeah? Yeah, I've been to church with my white friends, right? Sometimes they advertise that they finish at 10:30 and sometimes you can leave at 10. Jesus seems to understand when I'm with my white brethren. And for years I used to blame the pastor, but it ain't nothing to do with him in a black church. Black people, we sing the songs for too long. What song has 16 choruses? Because white church, they're no different from us. They sing the same songs as we do, but they sing them fast. They've got things to do. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus.
Black people, keep it real. We'll sing the same song.
I said it.
What is this? Then the pastor has the cheek to say, I'll see you at evening service. It is evening. I want to be better than my dad, because my dad was the guy, right, on the estate that would ruin all the football games that me and the boys were playing, right? My dad would call me one time, Kujo, come here. No, not dear, come here. No, there is dear, here is here. And guys, we all done this, innit? When your parents call you in and you start chatting foolishness to yourself because you're vexed. Yeah, my dad was like, Kujo, come here. I was like, what's wrong with you, man?
Shut the rubbish for. What do you want from me, you
know? Using all my calf muscle. Shut up!
Get me vexed! Ladies and gentlemen, my best friend growing up with this little white boy called Michael
Murphy. Michael had enough of what my dad was going on with.
Today, he had something to say.
Coach, come over here, mate. What's that about? Coach.
So only your dad, my mum calls me. What do I say? Shut up.
Can't you see I'm playing at? Coach, you can do the same, man. You're a big man. You're 11.
Now, you go in there and you let him have it. Now, there's a little part of me that believed in Michael's spirit. But I remembered he don't live in my house.
So I turned to my dad and said, Dad, what's up?
Go to the store and get me Ribena.
Hammersmith, this is all I said. Dad, can't you get it yourself?
That is exactly what I heard, ladies and gentlemen. It was 1 p.m., but it got dark real quick.
The pigeons weren't even flying anymore. They came down to warn me.
Don't say that, Black!
Now, there's three stages to when you disrespect an African parent.
The first one is laughter about something they don't find funny.
My dad heard my foolishness. He was like,
Okay. The second thing is they have to turn into Columbo and repeat the disrespect that just took place. They gotta break this down. So I am the father. The father. F-A-D-A. The father. The father asked the son to go to the store and get Ribena. The son replied to the father who created him and said, I should get it myself. Jesus, can you believe it? Myself, with my own hands. Ladies and gentlemen, that is all I remember. I woke up in the hospital messed up. I used to be light skinned. This is the bruise. My name is Kojo. God bless Felix Dexter. God bless. Peace.
Come on, brothers and sisters. You can do better than that. One more time for Kojo. All of our humor, whether we come from Jamaica, no matter where we are in the Caribbean, all of our humor, man, comes from that mother continent, Africa. All of it. Look, brothers and sisters, I've got to say, and I have to be completely honest with you, sometimes when I look around and I look out, and I've been doing this for about 35 years or so on the stage or whatever, and sometimes, have you noticed how clean the acts have been tonight? Isn't it beautiful? Isn't it that you can bring your grandmother or have some children, whatever? It's really important. And sometimes I despair. When I look and I see what's going on in the black community, you know, sometimes I get a bit disheartened down and I wonder, man, what's the future? What does it hold? Because I know who we are and I know what's promised to us if we would only do the right thing. And so this next person who's about to come on the stage, I've got to tell you, I've watched him grow up. But in truth, I bow to him because he is one of our best. He's one of our finest. He is multifaceted. And we must begin to appreciate the people that God has blessed and raised among us. And so without further ado, I really want you to show him some love, put your hands together, and welcome to the stage, one of our finest. Please give it up for Brother Akala.
Bless up, bless up, bless up. Nah, come on, be here. Why are my elders trying to make me blush for? But bless up, thank you so much. Listen, first of all, ladies and gentlemen, please, 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 can we make some noise for Felix Dexter, please, ladies and gentlemen? Let's not forget why we're here tonight, you know. For me, I was an 80s baby, right? So I grew up late 80s, early 90s, and I think a lot of the youngers growing up today don't realise what that moment was. As troublesome as things were, as bad as things were, as tough as that period was, the Real McCoy in particular, if you grew up watching the Real McCoy like I did, you know what that show meant to you. Like, it's hard to even explain how important it was. I remember there was one sketch, I don't know why this one sticks out to me and why I'm going to say this before I give a little acapella and be out of your hair, but there was one particular sketch where, I don't know which of the actors it was, they were sat on top of the television set. Do you remember the sketch? And the child calls their mum and says, Mummy, come. Look, it's black people on the telly. But they were sat on top of the television. Yeah, that's how real it was. And I remember Felix's, when he done the London Underground. You remember that one? And he took out the shotgun for the youth. He's like, £10 fine. You remember that one? So now, honestly, when Jeff gave me a call and said, listen, we're doing this memorial for Felix. I said, yeah, man, that's like, you have to come and show respect to that. People that have paved the way, people that have been there for you, and people that don't even necessarily know the impact they've had on you growing up, just you seeing them, them doing your thing, them making you laugh, them saying things you can relate to. So please, one more time for Felix Dexter, please, ladies and gentlemen. In the spirit of that, I'm going to give you a quick acapella that is from a project I did called Visions, and it's really, you know, it's a tribute to the ancestors, you know. Felix has passed to the ancestors now, and it's a tribute to other great ancestors who paved the way in the field that I do, which is the field of spoken word. It goes like this. As I stared into the shattered shards of glass, I could see the past and grasp the vast entire history of the rhyming art. The last of the great griots of Timbuktu, memorizing the secret histories, propaganda and truths. The ones considered too important to be written, they memorized it and rhymed it the earliest form of spitting. They spat it and sang it and played it upon the core of the drums we're talking to, but some chose to ignore it. Most griots praised the ruler, a few foretold a future where the corruption that had come into the kingdom would consume it. Rejected the new religion, they called it a mental prison, prophesized the worst conquerors coming and taking children. Of course they were ignored and banished, the court with a sword and vanquished like all truth tellers throughout history, but they never vanished, made it through the middle passage, never gave up the habit, passing on the stories and tradition so that we could have it. I saw as clear as day a griot trapped beneath the deck, buried him and vomit up into his neckline, shackled next to his younger sister already dead. Her rotten corpse don't even smell no more cause he has lost the sense. Still we sung the song of the warrior, giving heart to all the others trapped, rebellion ready to start. That is art, that's poems that bleed, songs mold history, the greatest gift ever given, the true mystery. Even when the drum was outlawed on the plantation, they kept beating it and singing in secret and maintaining. I could see the start of the Haitians in revolution, and what did they start it with? Invocations and music. I saw Bookman read his poem over drums, don't they call it rapping? Calling on the ancestors to help and make it happen. I could see Congo Square in 1895 when Reconstruction was crushed and the struggle then to survive. But the drum beat and the songs was not defeated. What this created, they now call jazz, but don't believe it. It's just another continuum in our tradition of our collective genius, whatever is our condition. Visions, I'm visited by visions, hardest to describe visions. I could call it my intuition, internal guide visions. We're calling them visions, but they are something more visions. I'm sure that you get them too, but you ignore visions. I'm visited by visions, hardest to describe visions. They call it my intuition, internal guide visions. We're calling them visions, but they are something more visions. I'm sure that you get them too, but you ignore. I could hear the Delta blues sung by sharecroppers or maybe it was the Malian blues from centuries before. I could not decide, the vibe was so similar. I was seeing without eyes, my mind was the cinema. Multiple dimensions at once and a million narratives. The joy of creating when what you're facing is so harrowing. The glass showed to me this hologram, hallucination, evolution, the MC from many different nations. I could hear the barbershop quartets or street corner preachers, poets of the Harlem Renaissance, some of the greatest teachers. I saw Marcus Garvey speaking far from calmly, rhythm and passion of a general commanding half his army. I could see Cab Calloway away, composing dictionaries of slang, doing early versions of the moonwalk, talking to his band, Mr. Duke Ellington composing, Ella Scatton, Howlin' Wolf, pulled a strap on execs that tried to scam him. I could hear Memphis Minnie or Rosetta Tharpe plucking the strings of a guitar like it's the griot's harp. I could hear Miles or Charlie Parker coming up right after Muhammad Ali, spitting the rhyme to make us cry with laughter. I could hear X-Tempo in Trinidad looking like a battle, Jamaicans covering blues before reggae was channeled. I saw my grandmother coming across the ocean in the opposite direction from where ancestors were stolen, bringing these traditions to Britain with 100,000 others. Lost is the child of the art, the four sexist mothers. I saw Cool Herb also leaving Jamaica, taking the sound system to the Bronx, changing the flavor. I saw Gil Scott, Heron, Lost Poets and Watts, Prophets, Uroy, Big Youth, all the early toasters was on it. I saw Tupac, born in a cell, his whole life flashed before me, and I'm sure you can tell his mission was uncompleted because his message went unheeded. Ghetto youth, only powerful leader that we're in need of. I saw Bounty Killer, Supercat, Ninja Man in Yellow, Smiley Culture, London Posse, Skinny Man and Mellow. I saw Cool G, Big Daddy Kane and KRS, Big L, Big Pun and Biggie, then later Rest. I saw every legend that I've neglected to mention, and every legend that I've never heard of, resting in heaven, whatever you want to call it, wherever spirits you're born with. Rest after the rest of the flesh returns to the soil. And I could see myself standing here, just a link and a chain that goes back centuries further than you think. And it was clear to me I'm a vessel and nothing more. Yeah, the cup is half full, I ain't got a clue who pours. And I could feel that time was not real, and the way we're told that everything that's ever occurred is here in this present moment. So it matters not what the media want to tell us, who don't understand our culture, just products they want to sell us. And it matters not half of the planet's never heard of we. These rappers rap bars, I write portions of eternity, certainly. If I live to old age or they should murder me, I gotta keep fighting, it's so much bigger than me personally. I felt exhausted and energized, tired and awake, a whole nother place in my mental state. After such an epic journey, I couldn't sleep. I stayed up the whole night, and this is what I write. I put the pen down at first light and knew the lyrics off my heart already, as if I wrote them before in another life. And it was clear to me our contemporaries are not contemporaries. I'm from another century. It seems that we was meant to be. Griot the MC, the people storyteller, from the palace to the village to the ship to city dwellers. I felt the visions guiding those times I was moving blindly, and how they shaped my life up to this point where you now find me. Whether you're living grimy or trapped by the current climate, the visions will always guide you, bro. You just gotta decide if you follow what you know, what's inside your fairy soul, or to be distracted by the 10,000 things that they promote. All this I understood just from the shattered glass. Looked up at the clock, time passed so fast. I swept up the glass from the floor and went about my day and came here to tell the story. Here is what I say. Visions, we're visited by visions, hardest to describe. Visions, you could call it my intuition, internal guide. Visions, we're calling them visions, but they are something more. Visions, I'm sure that you get them too, but you ignore them. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Big up. Shout out to Felix Desta. Enjoy the rest of your evening, ladies and gentlemen. Big ups.
Do we know what we've got? Come on, brothers and sisters, one more time. For Akala!
All right, all right, all right. Brothers and sisters, we have to become militant. Some of us get scared of that idea, but even the ants, the little creatures are militant. In Jamaica, we have some ants, we call them soldier ants. Everywhere they've got a march, and they're very, very organized. We've got to become a very organized people, a very united people, a very strong and powerful people, unapologetically. This next act, he's a soldier. He's been out there entertaining and giving us strong, powerful music for many, many years. Without further ado, I want you to put your hands together and welcome to the stage our brother, our soldier. His name is General Levy!
Yo. Respect. Greetings, massive. Original big bad General Levy in the building. Big up Jeff Schumann. All the crew them. What we tell them?
Big up the legend, Bob Man.
Yeah, man, big up all massive, all crew. Yeah, Felix Dexter. Rest in peace. What we tell them?
Yo, big up the legend, Bob Man.
London massive. What we tell them? Yo, Yo, give me the love, excellent, definite, me represent. Step into the resident, give me the right treatment, 100%. Nevertheless, give me the work was sufficient. At the end of government, me checking up the cabinet. Excellent, eloquent, under my Guinness and my sense. Read the body language like a text message. Excellent, we project, connect like magnet. Let's set up like Timothy, cause we have a market. I could love the girl them require. They should need a man to come and relight the fire. Bigger judgment, what the girl them desire. That's why you're general, you know them have to hire. Tell you good love, the girl them require. Say she need a man to come and relight the fire. Bigger judgment, what the girl them desire. That's why you're general, the Joe them have to hire. Yo, if it's loving what she need, send it into me. Send it, she receive it hotter than a pepper seed. Great height, what we reach, that type of ecstasy. We return excellence, hot like 90 degrees. Yeah, almighty, bless good girls like her days. Hot like fire, that's what we need. Give me the massive, it I must be fintamine. All of the posse, come and follow we. A good love, the girl them require. Say she need a man to come and relight the fire. Bigger judgment, what the girl them require. That's why a general, you know them have a higher. Hey, wicked, wicked. Wicked, wicked. Wicked, wicked. I am the Inca. Round and round, we big up the girls from around like a pound. Right now, General Lee for the workout. In them, big up the guy walk over gym and do them thing and keep them body in a trim. I rule a big size zoom, but I can't be swinging, keep your body moving. But take a swim. It's like a lion running on the treadmill, looking like you're going in. We love your style, we love your swag, we love your shape, we love your shift. How you work it, how you twerk it, how you turn and how you twist. The shape is like a gift, precious and sacred. So we have to cherish it, got this way from Christ. I'm your blessed, come you get it, and we love how you were sitting on it. No time we shake it, me just can't forget it. Good in your shape, style updated, in a good place. Your future's looking great. Big up on the gang, walk over gym and keep them body in a train. I love aerobics and Zumba, I keep the swing and keep your body moving. You take a walk, you take a run, you take a ride, or you could even take a swim. Hey, it's like now you're running on the treadmill, looking like you're going in. Well, some of them are lifting it up, some of them are twisting it up, some of them are pressing it up. We'll keep on them stomach, summertime is coming up. Need to eat your good food, vitamins and your calories. Eat your vegetable and drink up your smoothie. You was overweight, man. Look how you lose it. You suck at your fluffy, know you're bad and you're bougie. Aerobic, need to control it. Then ride the circuit, cause you know you're worth it. Bim! Pick up nigga, walk go watch him and do them thing and keep them body in a trip. Pull up! Yo! Come, come and do some old school tracks now. All right. Big up Jeff Schumann. And the girls who put on my shirt. I'ma tell them. And the girls who put on my shirt. It's eating on the plane, sir. And the girls who put on my shirt. Because eating on the place. Okay, okay, okay. Oggy, oggy, oggy! Oggy, oggy, oggy! Oggy, oggy, oggy! Someone! For the girls with sweet and unique. For the girl with the sexy physique. Because she like coming with. She the stop my feet. It's a rapid me of the heater. Turn on the heater, let me increase the fever. Me and the DJ, all right, can pick the temperature. I turn on the pepper, you put in on the pizza. More fire lyrics like an AK report. Lyrics never show a like fucking a show a lava. When they go down to lyrics, they never leave it for lava. All the girls, they meet in the place, leave me up in Kieta. Got them in my heart number. For the girls, so sweet and unique. For the girl, they win the sexy physique. Because she like coming with. She just stop my feet, it's not repeat. How do the girls don't put in my shape? Because it's heating at the place. How do the girls don't put in my shape? Set to the self street, because eating at the place of the prestige, girl. Put up on a hand. You're full of etiquette and sophistication. But don't ever get to down the eater, chill me with emotion. Now them time bug, I told you never leave it. I say what? How the girl don't tell them it's hot? They tell you for road come. Yo, I've got a question. I have a question for all the massive in here tonight. Do we have any junglist massive in the place tonight? Well, I'm gonna... We're gonna take them back. What you said, Jeff? Yo, feel free to have a skank to this one. Wicked, yeah, wicked. Jungle is massive.
Wicked, wicked, jungle is massive.
Wicked, wicked,
jungle is massive.
What we tell them?
Wicked, original.
We're big up on original jungle is massive. Yo. This is the incredible general. Boy. Yo, booyaka, booyaka, when the general pass. MB run the dance. And we don't take back no time. Booyaka.
Wicked,
jungle is massive.
Wicked, wicked.
Jungle is massive.
Wicked, wicked.
Jungle is massive. Wicked, original, we're bigger. All original jungle is massive. The original dancer jungle is there. Gentlemen, leave you alongside MB. The world's in trouble. He goes, I am the Inca about general. Sensation, I'm gonna come here. Inca about general. Help me out, massive. Money, well, I'm the massive. Them not gonna win, man. You don't feel the thought of the man we got. Dance can I tell you swimming fun? Girls here with rice in that they're drinking. Pass on me, I'm gonna pass on me, I'm gonna pull on me, I'm gonna chill. I got me no time for me now, over the hill. Who do want to see that? But I must say sick and I must say ill. This is the young people, I'm gonna go right your will. Okay, okay, okay. Okay, okay, okay. Okay, okay, okay. Okay, okay, okay. Booyaka, booyaka, when the general pass up. And me run the dance. Me don't take back no talk.
credit bad. Mr. Live from the man, they're gonna be a bit and I run up the map and I'm gonna be a wicked. I'm gonna try that. I'm gonna be a bit of a bit of a bit of a bit of a Let's see a shot, incredible. I'm the mammon, I'm the mammon, I'm the German, I'm in the mission. Respected by man, I love my cat. I'm in the place, in America. He's original.
Jungle is massive.
Hear this. Yeah, what we tell them? What we tell them? So what?
Let me to come to my heart, them. General, you come to my...
Yo! Man, they won't let them. I swing them like a windmill. New talk, but them got to them. And we got the skill. Just God, I'm not like my father.
Come to your way, boys. We get prepared. Wicked! And me to come to my heart, yeah.
Wicked, wicked!
And me to come to my heart.
Why yo, yo, yo? Why yo, yo, yo? Yaga, yaga, yo!
I wanna big up everybody here tonight. Yo, it's been a pleasure to pass through and do something for you.
Thank you.
Bless you. Thank you. Respect. Come fast.
Come on, brothers and sisters, one more time for General Levi.
Beautiful, beautiful. Wow. Who's staying on for the after party? It's going on till about 3 o'clock this morning, so we're about to go into that phase of things. But just before we do, brothers and sisters, I want us to welcome to the stage the principal organizer of tonight and the chairman of the Felix Dexter Foundation, who really made this happen. And so without further ado, please, let's put our hands together for our brother Jeff Schumann. Welcome, Jeff Schumann.
Hello, good evening. My apologies. Somebody told me where the guy who cussed the woman on Ryanair lived. And I got a bit excited with my foot. I just want to say, before I say anything on behalf of the Felix Foundation, a day of positivity. We were wonderful in the day. We had drumming workshops. We had an African market. We had a debating society. And there could really only be, Akala was coming, Felix was a very, very positive person, but there could only really be one person who started the mission of what we call edutainment in this country when he was Leo Chester, then Leo X Chester, and then Leo Muhammad. And I just want to say, for those who don't know, get to know, will you please, for your compere tonight, on a day of positivity, our brother, Salil Muhammad. It's for me to say, okay, first and foremost, who's staying for the dance? We've got 4 hours. Well, three and a bit, because when it gets 2 o'clock, it goes back to 2 o'clock, and then we're going to stay, dance, drink, sing, make noise for Felix. Thank you from the bottom of my heart. When my friend died 5 years ago, I was in Romania when I got the news that he was in a very bad way. And so I lied and I told them, because we weren't technically blood, but I told them that my brother was ill in hospital. So they released me, they let me leave Romania, and I came and I saw Felix. I took a couple of pictures, I got very emotional. And then the following day he died. And I absolutely was inconsolable. Because of my journey, we used to write together. Felix got into the Royal McCoy, a guy called Terry Jervis, unfortunately couldn't be here. Terry came to see Felix at the Comedy Store. Felix phoned me as Jeff Shuley, he'd seen me on the university circuit doing characters and said, look, the BBC are interested in me for a program called The Royal McCoy. He didn't used to watch it. I said, with jealousy in my heart. They never called me. And he said, do you want to write with me? And in those days, I was doing a character on the circuit called Ghanaian Greg, who was a West African who was so anti-West Indian, he didn't know who he was. And then we came up with Nathaniel, the minicab worker, who had about 1,000 jobs. Then we were the Cockney, do you know what I mean? Give it a slap and all that, do you know what I mean? And then Douglas, when we nearly got the sitcom, where I was going to play his younger brother, the posh-spoken, because we both went to university. But the difference was I completed, Felix dropped out. But he didn't make a bad choice. Look what he went on to do. And for all of you who bought tickets to came, who came out tonight to support this event, we put this together inside of 6 weeks. When the council agreed that they would allow us to have the facility, I'm going to bring out the secretary of the organisation, Yvonne Wilson, in a moment. We met in her office. We brought in a brother called Jide. I love you, Jide, wherever you are. And a woman, a sister called Diane, the four of us sat and we planned and we talked about what could we do to mark his 50th year anniversary, because a number of young people don't know who he is. And we want to keep his legacy alive. And I have to ask you, if we get the chance to do something like this again next year, will you come out and support it? Me in particular, I'm passionate about how my culture, and in particular, as I'm a black man, how we're portrayed. This is the controversial part. I'm not against anybody, and good luck to whoever's doing whatever. But you see the brother Akala, you see Leo, and you see me now. I don't do what I used to do when I did stand up. What we're trying to do is change the narrative as to how we as black men are perceived. You can't leave, you cannot leave the parenting, you cannot leave. And this is what will upset some of you, but I'm going to say it as a mature man. We cannot leave the parenting of our children to Channel 4. Those clapping, you know what I'm talking about. We're the only race who are actually encouraged to sing about wickedness and our own demise and don't challenge it. And when men like me challenge it, oh, he's jealous. Akala's jealous. Leo's jealous. No, we're not. What we're saying is, we're more than just that. There are people in this room, similar to myself, we work, we're functioning, we pay our bills. Channel 4, elements of the BBC, they're not interested in those stories. Now, if I shoot somebody in here tonight, or rape someone in here tonight, that's the programme they're going to put on air. So, don't clap. It's what are you going to do if I said, can we go and march on Channel 4 to tell them? Because they're the most guilty at this moment in time. We would like other things to be commissioned as well. None of you, 5 of you might join me. Everybody be on Facebook. Thank you, my sister. We have to stop it. This day of positivity about Felix, because he was positive. We did a whole day, got Leo to host it. I phoned Akala. I said, you have to come. Even if it's just for five, you have to come, Akala, and address them. And that's my next mission, to try and get Akala on television, doing what he does best, representing us in a positive kind of way. That's the next major move. So I say to you all, Yvonne Wilson, where are you? Where's Yvonne? Is Yvonne back? Ladies and gents, where's Yvonne? Is Yvonne, where's Yvonne Wilson? Where's Yvonne? Yvonne. The secretary of our organisation, the Felix Dexter Foundation, we can only grow if some of you join us. Before you leave tonight, we need help with admin. We've got website support, we've got technical support, but we need more of you to join us to not only just promote Felix's legacy, but so we can do more positive nights like this. To get I can get artists, they're my friends, to come out and perform for you at sensible prices, and every penny goes to charity. Not no radio station owner that won't support this event. Not people who send out weekly bulletins who knew they were coming here and didn't send nothing out. Well, not me, I'm saying it's Jeff Schumann. I just observe behaviour. May now beg anybody. May now beg anybody. 100 black men, thank you very much. Dunstan and your crew for supporting the Felix Foundation. It's well noted. This is Yvonne Wilson. Honestly. Yvonne joined myself. I went to Yvonne 4 years ago and I said, I need a sister who shares similar ambitions and opinions on what is wrong in our community. We just need that some of the elders to stop pointing the finger at our young people. Our young people have been miseducated. We ourselves have been miseducated. But it's what we do about it once we come into knowledge of self. And when we have knowledge of self, we put on events like this. And we encourage you to come out and see artists. So who on this stage tonight embarrassed our community? Let me tell you something now. You watch the BBC in 2 weeks' time. Again, you're going to get upset with me, because I say what they keep pushing in front of us. It's a new game show on BBC One with an English host and a black woman who just seems to laugh loud and loud and loud and loud and loud and loud. She's on This Morning. They call her Alison. That's the image. If it's not her, it's Ainsley. That's what they want us to do all the time, is to have no political opinions, open our eyes like this and laugh loud. So, absolutely. So it's not an attack on the sister, not an attack on Big Nasty. These are the things they portray on us all the time. I'm going to ask Yvonne, because she didn't want to speak, but I'm going to bully her now. Make her say a couple of words. But yeah, but you want to go and run off. Ladies and gents, please, Miss Yvonne Wilson.
God, he can talk, can't he? Okay, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Haven't rehearsed anything because I actually wasn't going to get up on the stage today, but one of the things that I do love is when I see my fellow black brothers and sisters together laughing, sharing, enjoying memories. But the Felix Dexter Foundation for me is more than just we come here and laugh and joke. How many of your children play chess? Put your hands up. How many of your children have ever seen a chessboard and said, "Mom or Dad, teach me how to play chess"? How many of your children do African drums? How many of your children can hold a debate? Now, I'm not talking about certain debate. Yeah, I'm talking about sitting down, having a conversation when they go into college or into university and someone is actually disrespecting them, and being able to talk on a level that someone has to stand up and listen to. That's what the Felix Dexter Foundation is aiming to do. It's aiming to give our children a voice. In addition to that, Felix Dexter left a legacy for children. Many of us, we come and go, we've had people that have passed, and we talk about what we would do. This is a man that on his deathbed said, "I want to give something back to my island." Many of us are here. We grew up with parents who fought. They went to hell and back for us. But how many of us remember the islands where we're coming from and actually do something? Yeah? Felix Dexter has done that. So for me, the legacy is about growing not just St. Kitts, but growing the Caribbean. and further afield, Africa. Because if we don't realize who we are as a people and where we need to go, we are in trouble. Our children are on the streets every day. I'm gonna challenge you that next year, I don't want to just see all the parents and all the adults. I want you to bring one child with you. Bring them to the debaters. Bring them to the chess. We will make it enjoyable. You don't have to do that. All you have to do is bring them. And I'll tell you now, the Felix Dexter Foundation will be there year on year, building on the legacy of what's been left. And I'm not going to talk anymore. Thank you very much. Good night.
So,
I just want to say, because I know some people haven't seen me for a while, I look slightly different. White people are fantastic when they see me. They really are. Well done, Jeff. Oh, wow. You've lost weight. Black people, wicked, you see. They all look at me, and when I walk past, me is same sick. Another virus. I'm here. Remember one of them drastic band business? Yeah, I'm here. Let me tell you something now. If I had a gastric band inside me, I used to eat so much, I'd have eaten that as well. It's wonderful to see so many brothers and sisters who are here and to see the young children who are here. I know what Yvonne just said. I don't know how old you are. I hate young people. I'm going to be honest with you. I hate them because I'm jealous of them with a passion. I've just come back from Atlanta where I injured myself and saw young black children on the plane talking about where they were going for next year's holidays. Can I just tell you something, young lady, about where my generation went during the summer holidays? Those laughing know where we're going. We used to go to a place called the park. And we created our own entertainment. There were you sitting there. Can I just ask, do you get pocket money? Pocket money. I'd never heard of pocket money until my white friends told me. In fact, I didn't know the government gave my parents money for me till I became a parent. I thought child benefit was a charity dance. But you're lucky, and I respect you. You get Christmas presents? You do? You do what? Christmas presents? Yeah, no one's talking to you. Shush. No wonder your child will get in trouble. I'm not talking to you. You know, it's like, you know, young kids get Christmas presents. I got school clothes. To last forever. I am from the generation where, you know, if you have a family more than three or four, you pass down clothes. I had three sisters. All size 10. Batty used to kill me. Yesterday, in Hammersmith and Fulham, I thought schools were off. I saw five black boys, five, at a bus stop, kicking a tin can with them school shoes. I don't think you heard me. Kicking tin can with school shoes at 5:10. 5:10. My generation, I finished school at 3:30. I lived 25 miles from my house. By 3:35, I was home. And what's the first thing you did as a black child when you got home from school? You take your school and you put on your playing night clothes, them tight clothes, and your batty lights off. Remember? We must love our children. We must stop criticizing our children. We must stop condemning our children. We must try and observe our children. I leave you with this thought. If we, forget other cultures, if we don't police ourselves, nobody will do it for us. Some of you in this room, if I mention the word drill, you might think I'm talking about DIY. This thing called drill music is poison, where our young men are actively encouraged, actively,
make videos and talk about harming each other. It took for the Metropolitan Police Commissioner, Cressida Dick, to tell YouTube to take those videos. Not us. It took the so-called enemy who identified that these young men were poorly educated, and we as a community, we sit by in silence. And then when we start to make noise is when someone dies in custody or someone makes jerk rice, then we protest. You know what's coming next, don't you? Jerk Jaffa cakes, that's next. That's coming next. So the reality is, let's protest sometimes. Let's protest sometimes. Let's protest sometimes for our betterment. If you see something on television and you're like, that's offending me. This is what they keep on pushing for our children to see. Loud, laughing, never having an opinion. Why do I love Akala? Why do I love Felix? Why do I love Leo? There's an opinion there. It's not for everybody. Paul General Levy, we were in Barbados for a week. And I watched that man do all kinds of stuff. But the mutual love we have for each other, well, I picked the phone up to all these performers. Jeff, we're coming for Felix. Not coming for me, we're coming for Felix. So I ask you, ladies and gents, we're going to play some wicked music. Before you leave, there's the information desk out there. Any little time or skill you have, please join the Felix Foundation. Thank you, my darling. I'm not sure if you want to come up here and become a double act with me, because you love shouting. I'm okay, I'll see you. But thank you, my sister, for talking them talk there. So ladies and gents, for all the performers who performed tonight, please give them a massive round of applause. I've got to make a couple of apologies. Richard Blackwood has been calling to do some filming. That's why he couldn't be here tonight. So we apologise profusely. Wayne D.B. Rollins was doing something up in central London. Something happened. We're not quite sure. I'm going to leave here and check on Wayne. Something happened in central London with Wayne this evening. So D.B. couldn't be here. But everybody else, as you know, came and did something. So please, go to the bar, get something to eat. We've got 3 hours of wonderful music inside. I want to say to the men them inside, be careful. Ladies, if any man asks you to dance, please say yes. You can't get pregnant by dancing. It is just a dance. Nobody wants to start a family. Just a dance. Fellas, if a woman gives you a mobile number tonight, don't take it. She has a man. You want the landline number, 0207, 0208, 0203. If she give you 015, she lives too far. So ladies and gents, on behalf of the Felix Dexter Foundation, good night, God bless. My name is Jeff Schumann. I'm not even religious. Thank you so much.